Good to see you. See you.
Senator, how are you? Good to see you.
We had something to say to you.
Do you expect the summit will get you closer to an arms agreement, sir?
These are softballs. These are softballs.
No. No. Let's just make it a photo opportunity, because I know somebody's waiting there with a knuckleball.
Last Thursday was the last proposals. The third round, I think we all agree.
Good morning. Good to see you. Thank you. Thanks very much. Thank you. You and I are going to do something. Hi, how are you?
President,
good to see you and to have you here.
You know, Kurt O'Donnell.
You're not only president.
Yes, hi.
Today between the two shack of
Ireland, and the Prime Minister of England regard the Northern Ireland and trying to finally settle the tragic and amazing warfare that has been going on there. We're delighted that this has come about, and we hope that in a bipartisan way that we can go forward with anything we can do to help, as they have agreed to the two governments to help in restoring sound economics there, and anything we can do to encourage private investment to provide prosperity and employment for their people. But it has been, we think, a great breakthrough and shows great promise. Now,
well, thank you, Mr. President. I think it is very courageous on the part of the leaders of the English government and the government of Ireland to get together to try to work out and solve the problems of Northern Ireland. There in the land of culture, yet 90 miles from the European continent, there has been hundreds of killings and thousands of woundings. And it has showed through the years that bullets and bombs are not the answer. The answer is talking the question over, and I'm glad that both of these countries have appreciated the severity of the question. America has flourished because of diversity, and there's no reason that Northern Ireland can't be the same way. And so I stand here beside the President of the United States, proud of the fact that we both support the leaders of those two great nations, the Taoiseach and the Prime Minister. And I want to assure you how delighted I am that America is backing a policy which all presidents have said that if we could bring this to an end, we would do everything that we humanly could. And as Speaker of the House, Mr. President, any means that we can use in the Congress of the United States to help bring peace in Northern Ireland, I assure you that we'll have the full cooperation of the Congress. There's no question in my mind. So again, we congratulate the people of Ireland, the leaders, and the people of England, Mrs. Thatcher, the Prime Minister, and our hope and our prayers and our best wishes and our support is with them that this venture will be a success.
Mr. President, Speaker O'Neill is predicting major results at the summit in Geneva next week. Do you agree with him?
This was that knuckleball I was talking about yesterday. So something I prepared not to take any questions here. We're not going to take questions here at this particular occasion. Statements of initiative, but when you ask one like that, the speaker standing here, yes, I am very pleased and delighted with what he had to say.
I want you to know that we wish you all success and happiness and best wishes and in the moment the greatest results. Everyone in America, you're our leader, and we know that you're going to have success.
Thank you.
Mr. President, Mr. Arbatov today in Geneva calls you a great B movie actor.
He's never seen King's Road.
One of the reasons.
Photo op, so let's go.
Mr. Speaker, are you disappointed you're not going to be in the
Oh, I got Peggy Whit holding the job for me.
Thank you very much.
That's send over those capital. I'm going to give you a bit against my opposition to proposals. If you only use the plus line. So the president, you get a bit, you're going to go back. Churches and pension line, the awards, and the rest of the absolutely.
Percentage of debt, 4%, 8%, 2%, 3%, and then running continued in those 2 years to be balanced. Somebody says, we can't go a year after year to see how we're going to reduce the deficit. If we don't, there's no way.
Listen, for the next, to get off the plane and to address the American people and with them, million percent, every year, so what, you got my right arm if you want.
Yeah, but maybe a couple of times, but we might have to bring it up. Listen, you think that's about, what do you agree with one year?
Step back, Mr. President.